Hello guys, this is Johan Forsblom, and I'm back now after a long time. It's been the summer, it's been moving to a new apartment, it's been, well, lots of things. So as you see here, it's written to be the 30th of April and August 2018 tutorial. So what we will cover today is how to fix the depth sorting drawing, and I'll show you the problem real soon. And we're going to create some collision detection here. Alright, so we should get started. Get started, the things we need to do. So first off, we can go draw this thing here and show you what the problem is with the drawing here. So if we draw it down to a special tree down here that I know has this, where we can like display the problem here. So you see, everything is drawing nicely and fine when we're zooming the out, you know? So normal resolution, but as I zoom in. And there you see, the tree is being drawn on top of the player. So, what's the problem here? Well, the problem is when we are zoomed out, we have a lot of trees here. And as we zoom in, these trees are still in the array. And we are not checking but they're still in the same row, so trees being drawn row per row. And when we zoom in, we still have trees in the buffer, which we have not cleared, and I'll show you where that is. So here, system run isometric for it. So let's see it up here. See, I think we were just surface, yeah, here. Here's where we are drawing all the entities, and we're just saying as long as the entity here it's not in the same row. We are getting, we're just gonna keep on drawing. So what we need to do is to insert a check to make sure that we're not drawing these unnecessary trees anymore that are not visible on the screen. So what we have to do is add a simple if statement here. If entities on screen player dot entity weight. If we take entities on screen player dot current entity to draw. No, that's not folder. Sorry, I'm doing the wrong thing here. Layer dot current here. Layer the current entity draw, and then check if this is larger or equal to entities on screen. Layer dot. Now entities here. And if this is the case, you just break the loop. Break out of the loop. For entities has being drawn like so. So, and as you can see here, what we're doing is we're never resetting the array. So, we're saying, hey, if we reach the first entity, if the loop has been completed and we reach the first entity, we're just going to say we don't have any entities here. And the current number of entities is always zero. But because we're drawing, we're putting them in the buffer in the array. And that's the problem we have. So if we go build our one now. Let's bring that friend over here and run down to that tree where we know we have the problem. There you go. And let's zoom in. And we're now drawing as we should. So that's fixed. Next up is we are going to create some nice things here. I'm going to make sure I got my notes set up here as well. And let's get to it. Easy as component. I started writing on the component, animation component, but we'll get to that later some other time. So let's go here, add files. Component and collision. H. Okay, I'm gonna add. Oh, sorry, I'm creating a new one up here. Yes, please. And the right folder as well. Component. Collision. H. Just copy that. Just gonna create the C file as well. All right. New empty file, yes please. Component collision, let's see. Like so. I guess all with the H file here. If in depth. Component, just copy something. Collision dot H. The header already in there, and we can also include our SDL2, SDL dot H banner. We need a random ISO engine as well. Enum, I'm gonna make some collision type there. Collision type. Updated. Type this morning, apparently. Right, this is work. I'd like to be entity. The other way. I'm going to have a quick little time on there. Second typing. Collision. Yeah. precision type. Create collision the rectangle function as well. Entity, and we throw in an SDL. Right. Collision right. Like so. Bring those friendly things in here, into the C file here. Do you want to increment them as well? Includes SDL family now. Then you want to have system.h. You want to have system collision.h, which we haven't written yet. So we'll get to that in a minute. I think I'm writing on the... Oh, we can do that later. This is actually another file. I'm not going to write the system now. I'm writing the component, so... Standard list, which would be... Include... Take a break because my door just came in here. Alright, back to your business. Alright. Function. Door new collision. Well, I'm not reading. There you go. Sorry, we don't want a collision to be activated for any entity in the beginning, so set up right. I'm just going to give it some more values here. So we're going to use entity. Return the collision component. only take maybe 4. You could. You can use your components. Spell today. All entities. There you go. To be activated and create the whole situation and right angle. And we will return the point to the collision components. Type and if the collision component not null, then we will say not collision and pk dot collision type equals collision type. So, good. Collision type. That was quite too long. Point to collision point is null. There you go. This will be a little similar, so we'll just get that one. That is null. Sure things are okay, and we can point that one instead. And if collision right, if that is null, we want to do the same thing here. The pointers are not null. Okay, good. And so we have a parameter. It's null. And if they're in the status. We return out of the function as well. Position component entity dot right equals position right to get the reference attribute value. Like so. the component is not funded to null, no, we want to free it. Next up, we should do all our cool things inside of the scene. It's been a while since I've been around this code, so there is a good starting place, I think. You can add some common thing here. Oh, we haven't added this to the set yet, that's nice. So we need to do that as well. So we need to go to our component page here. And now, you see here, we don't have this here, so we have to first add our component type count there. Component type 1. Like so. And go to the scene. Make sure we don't have too many errors. Here we have our collision. Collision component here. New collision. And we have a component tag, which is wrong. One tag pieces a collision component here. Nice. velocity keyboard. Mouse, and we need a render 2D component here. Name tag, and here's where we add our collision component. I think I'd add it as a point in the top as well. Yeah. Size of strapped. Collision. It's been another game where memory for the collision component is good. We have to find the next component set thing here. Move, okay. Collision, and we need one of these ones as well. Component collision here, and let's go somewhere else here and fix this component collision. There you go. And we say that component collision there equal to, yeah, now we're gonna move those as well. Find the next set. If we have one. Yep, we do. Here we go. Component set collision. Like so. Else have too many arguments. Component, free component collision, yeah. Because we are setting in the we don't need to do through the max entities on this one, so that's why. Well, cool. Next up, we need to make the system. Now you can't find the door again, so another pause here quickly. Okay, let's continue here. We're going to make the system now here. So, new file here. Yes, I'd like to add it to my things here. System.h. And let's create another file here for system collision.c. I have it over here. And we have our system functions here, and system the same name. Push it up, take. Tuition free. Is there nice? We can bring up that system pushing it. So I don't have too many things up here. Clean. Don't do that. That's right. Did not save the right place. Fine. Well, I don't know what's going on. Oh, it's complete. Okay, good. Good. Bike. Okay. Water. Water. We want to turn down the timer. And we want to have a scene. We also want to have our ice engine. And we're going to try for that one, yeah. And let's define the system. Pollution mask. Step one, just go the component. Position, and we will have our component. Yeah. Somebody that needs my attention here. Okay, back again here. That's live from your parent. Okay, where were we? One of the velocity as well. Local point into the scene as well. So we don't have to be referencing. Get components. Get the velocity components. partition. Tell me about the 2D. Render 2D, okay. Cool, we updated it. To simple engineer it. Just a phase initialize. See. Let's see. Parameter. Yeah, I forgot one thing, we need to type cost the scene as well. Scene key. There we go. So we have to have our scene set up, scene, ice engine. There's no. Sometimes you do things in the wrong order, but it works out anyway. This time it did at least. But here we have to fly that system thing. Type later on. We got the pointer here for it, so. And here we go. If I send it. copy the whole part here and just paste it and change the text. And then does not have a map. If you have the position components, we have to write some stuff about that as well into the log file. Now I'm going to check the collision components as well, so let's pop the whole thing again. Render 2DT and we need a render here as well. There we go, so successful means write. This is, I can write some log file about that as well. Okay, next up we have the void system coalition update. There is no thing. To go to our system render ISO world and add a function here as well. Kind of simple here. Entities on screen key system and isometric world. Get on screen play. Files here. Like so. And we will return to our collision system here. Render. There you go. We'll have to write layers and we'll think a bit which one it will be. I'm going to take it from layer 1 because on layer 0 we don't have the tiles. On layer 1 we'll put. Yeah. Go like that. System collision update entity. And 32 entity. The system player to initialize. He's going to return out of the function. Now push one point, entity, well, collision type, deactivated. And render, of course. And let's see if we can do it. That's a long one. I'm checking my notes here as well to make sure I'm not missing something here. If we have a system collision mask set, there we go. If the entity can collide, the world. Type world and entity. Then we will handle entity world collision here. Like so. Or else if entity. Skip it, so yeah, that will handle and the collisions here. Cool, that was that function. And we have to do our collision. Right. 2 and 14 to the lens. Dot red dot h. And then the bottom left one. And this is the bottom right one. Like so. I check my notes to see if I'm missing something. Plus the ISO engine scroll X is basically so camera X position should rename those to camera X and Y if you wanted to. Y and the scroll Y. Like so. That's engine covered. Two of these coming here. Point. Apply the offset. See if we have to update this one. See dot offset. What about ice engine? Zoom low. Disable the Y position here, so we will adjust things according to that. And we have to go and do a minus here. minus the total intensity. And I'll break and get the width of that. So you know how far to use this as easy to get the center of the texture here. To move the sprite back to the center basically. And right. Why is the engine and the zoom level of course? Like so. And here we will start. Oops. Start at the bottom. And this is how we set up the rectangle for the position that we will check against. And this is the X position. And it's going to be, the Y is going to be a little bit different. Because we're moving the whole, we're checking at the base. Here, when we're checking the X, we're pushing the collision point into the center of the sprite. And we are at the bottom, we're going to push it just with the, we're going to start from the bottom. That means we're not going to have this move. We're not going to multiply with C plus 5, otherwise we'll be moved to the center of the whole thing, of the sprite. So we're just going to go minus the width, and so at the height here, of course. Let's do some adjustments. Y, or Y. This is going to be. Yeah, we got something. I'm typing. Messing up the thing here. Okay, so 0.5 here and 0.5 there. Get the center, and here we're just going to take minus the bottom, the height basically. So we saw the bottom of this fight. There we go with. Okay, we need to add a thing here that we don't have yet and do a code. So we're gonna go to the system of ISO earlier. I'm sorry, ISO C here. So did I move that last time? I think I did. Yeah, so I'm gonna get this one out of here and put that inside the page here. So we need to access these ones outside. And add one here, so we're using 32. Non entities. Cross render. There we go. We need to add these guys in here as well. It's a sort entity, yeah. This is the place we're added to. We see the entities on screen. I thought. Don't have this false render. Don't be sure the entities on screen. I thought non entities. There you go. Jump into these lost window. The entity is not itself. There you go, we're not trying to draw, do something collision, do a collision with ourselves, so that's great. Well, collision rectangle for the on-screen entities. And do this, I got entity ID. Is this collision? And this I got into the ID that will write. Here we also have that something to the position component as well. And if we hit file here, system. And we go position dot h. So for now, I think we're gonna add a little array here to that at least. I think we're gonna have to save. We'll have a storage for like three previous positions if you want to. Position. Position. Position history. Three frames. Oh, why? Position system, a component position, C. And in here we have to add need to initialize these guys as well. And I gotta get to work now, so I will continue with typing the rest of the collision system once I get back. So right here, I'm having a quick break, and well, I'm having a long break, but you will see this 2-3 seconds. So see you later, or real soon. Okay, let's continue. So we're down here, and we're going to add. If there's a collision, we're going to take the position columns. Or entity dot x. And we're going to set position to call this 0 for now. So we're going to do a simplify the collision detection here to get everything working easily. So what we're doing here are colliding. We're just going to reset our position to the old position we had last frame, basically. And yeah, that up here, yeah. Hope that's fine. Anyway, we made a work fiction, yeah, good. And we get those things, that's good. You see, I don't know where I am, so. We need a point 2D here. Check the width of the rectangle upwards. Plus components and E dot X plus X divide that with the ice in here. And the title size. Like so. Oh. Again, the table was really off there. The Y is going and title size as well, right? Put the tile under the entity. Get tile, and I see entity nice amount. The point of X and the point of Y. Run to any other components and entity dot layer here. The time is valid. If you run the function here, it returns if. This does minus one if it's not a valid tile, so. And we're just gonna add a simple, for now, this is a temporary thing. We're just gonna add a simple tile collision for the block we have in our tile set. So later on we're gonna add a list here so we can make it to do here. Add a list of tiles that collidable. isn't that right, man? Oh, that can't be connected. The tile equals 2. Reset the position if we collide with the tile. Let's copy this code here again. It's going to be really similar. And we check the downwards. Minus x and minus y is the tile, and if you tile this, and now it will loop. And system collision boundary box. SDL, right. Earth A, Earth B. So, I have forgotten to comment these ones before, so to do this right, the collisions here, different size, so B.x plus B.w, this is a corner, and that is larger than the A.x. So I'll describe this one for you later on. Right now I'm just gonna get everything running and oil system free collision system. Nothing here, nothing to free. System is not allocating anything in memory. Okay, expected identify before. Oh. Scene is null, of course. expected semicolon. Point X. Yeah, you need those. Something really nice here. This is a collection. Yeah, okay. This is the problem. It's supposed to be a bracket there. Entity ID. Yeah, missing a parenthesis now. There you go. Sometimes you're tired. The entities on screen is not the function or pointer. It's early in the morning here, so it should be working. Entities on screen later. Yeah, of course. We need just the brackets here. And not the parentheses, so that's the problem. And we go build. Cool. I'm checking my notes now to see. I'm thinking I'm missing something here. Hopefully things will turn out the way I thought they would, eventually. So let's go to our C file here. And we should start adding our component collision. Collision is null, like so. And I'm going to take a friend and put him down here. Get the collision components on the telephone. Collision T can get to from the scene. Get component scene. Component set one collision. Like so. To the scene as well, and add the systems to the scene. And I put the collision system after we have moved scene. System to scene, test scene, system collision. Okay, where is that guy? I don't think we have added it to system.h yet. No, we have not. Include system collision.h. System collision. System collision, that's good. I think that should be it. Well, that some collisions with our things as well to the player entity. Here we go. And we want to have a put that in here. The panel. Collisions, the entity will handle collision, collision type, collision component, and collision entity. Set up right. A small title for the eye to fit his feet. Component collision set collision rectangle.
so. One of the trees on the map. So we have a lot of things here. Learn the GUD. Opponents have velocity and. Component set 1 collision, like so. Could add one up here as well. Collision component, so that would work as well. Go create or set the I might just create the type the collision rectangle for the tree. Set up right temp right 0.0 and I'm gonna make it 20.20. Collision set, collision rectangle, and we get the collision on the entity and another temp vector that was just created. And we're going to change another thing in the code as well, and that is I'm going to check the log file and see exactly the string that we are using for this. Let's give me a few seconds. I can look it up, it should be in the. Oops, added there. Nope, I'm going to check the log file quickly, so save some time. Sorry guys, I didn't have my folder up here, so I gotta go do it first. Let's see, that's the one more. Put in here, and yeah, this one, we're not going to try it every time we're adding something to the scene in the log file, because that's going to mess things up if we do a lot of entities and say you allocate 30,000 entities, and you're going to have 30,000 lines with that message in the file. And what the standards are like when you're writing to a file, opening and closing as we are every time we are writing it to the log reading. So, let's head back. Adding trees to the scene. That's better. Like so, and build two few arguments, collision entity, of course. Here, about that one. Build. See if it freaks. Now we get if we got something here. ECS seen as is good system, ECS get system name ID6 is not name, so that's cool. I like when you have we have our things that we need to fix up. Move system, it was a summon system, control entity system, so we're just going to copy that one, and like so. System collision. And this one is going to call the system collision. In it, like so, and this will be system collision update. Update entity. Okay, like so. System collision free. Okay, so is it there again? No, it's a colon, so there was some colon here. Build system collision free. So let's go have a look in our collision system stuff here. System and click level collision here. System collision free. It's supposed to be right there. Unless we have not included it in the right place here. Find reference to system collision free. Go to the definition. Didn't I write that one perhaps? It's right here. And system, let's see them. Oh yeah. That's the name. Cool. So now it's better. So make sure the game starts. It slows down. Let me check the wall and see what's going on. Yeah, I'm gonna have a break and see where things are stopping, so you have to watch that as well. So I'll be back later, or soon.
And we should open up our scene here. And I found that we are doing some weird things here. We are setting the component collision, but we are overwriting the new component name tag, which is not a good thing. So we have to fix this little thing here. Make sure I got my notes set up properly as well here. This one, yes. Name tag component thing here. Max amplitude. So what we need to do here is to change the component collision. A dot collision type equals collision type deactivated. Rectangle, and we set up the component collision. J dot. We just initialize it just as we did in the code. New component. position like so. I'm going to continue to look for the component name, set name type thing to see if we missed some more things here. And it shouldn't be a problem, neither should that be. The other one, let's see if this is running now. Oh, it's running, but we are not moving at the moment, so. I'm getting the key presses, but our character is not moving, so I must have done something in the input. Well, I'm taking a quick break to see where I messed things up here, so be back shortly. Okay, so the problem is that we have not set this comment, this time was out of comment, I don't know when that happened, but save, and if we go build and run, we will have the movement in. And we can move around, but this is a collider, I think we have not set the old positions and stuff, so as soon as we collide, we are flipped back there. So what we have to do is we have to go to our position component here. And we're going to write a new function here. Void component position at old position to stack component position. Position T the position component and using entity like so, and this is going to be a little bit hacky I think, but we'll get to it. The position is not null, we just say that position component entity dot old x to equals 1 you could do this in a for loop later, but now it's just a few open, so I need to more than a few simple things. Like so, change this to the Y as well here. Headers, as engine, component and component position. Add it to stack, and we are going to do a nice change in the move system now. in the system about this entity. Values in the collision builder that should not be there. I'm gonna have a quick check here in the collision system. I'll get my notes up for this as well. So. Taking a quick break to see what's wrong here, and you don't have to see me reading my code too much here. Okay, they have a little bug here. Of course, it shouldn't be X here, it should be Y. So, if we go back to our component position, let's see, and that's the place where I found it. So, we want to see if this little thing is working now. I'll bring this to you. Here we go. And we are now colliding the tree. Nice. Cool, now what about the blocks? Blocks work nice as well. Yes, cool. We now have some collision detection here. So how about draw some bounding boxes as well? That should be in our system render ISO world. Maybe sure I got this set up in my notes as well. Isometric object code, that should be okay. Collision block that base of the object. So I think this is going to be pretty much the same code as we have in our system. Should be Question is, what we name that thing? Do we have collision components even here? So that's a good, that's a good thing to know. We don't have them right there, so we need to add them up to our. Just take the name of it. Call the components. Component solution. T equals null. We need to add this to our update function here. Collision T and our ECS scene get component scene and set one collision like so. Here as well, and they do it like that. Collision components, component collision here. Now we need our collision here, so all that stuff. Component collision. Okay, that's not allocated. Okay, cool. Now we have them in, we can get that stuff and find it in our feature components here. See the room. I think it should be pretty much the same. Did we name our components here? Render 2D components, so that's not going to work. Blocks though, but that's not needed. So That's it, basically. We have now done our collision detection for the world and for the entity, so we can move around the world and colliding stuff. So this concludes this next tutorial part. And we can see if we have gained any performance since that last time, because I've updated the code to use 64 bits instead of 32 bits code. Compiled with GCC 64 bit version now instead. So let's have a look here and see what we can do. I need to go to the anything close code here. No, sorry, the renderer. So you bring the one go. One time. And we can see what kind of FPS we have. Semicolon is missing. Blue and one. I'm going to draw so a few entities, there's not really much to look at. We have 800 FPS with when we're running up this. So we added another couple of thousand trees. Should be a difference. Mm-hmm. 10,000 trees. And we have to put them also in a more confined space, like 432, so we get all of them on the screen at the same time. A bit of a run. And here we go. Here comes the trees. We're drawing everything, even through the collision boxes. We have 13 FPS. So if we remove the collision boxes. Oh, nice. We have some kind of crash here. Close the program. I have to do some memory checking, I guess, to see if I'm not freeing the memory. Anyway, we can still do a nice change here. And go to the system, renderize world here. We can comment out the draw code. I'm going to run that again. Give it a run. And if you remember earlier, we had like 19 FPS, and now we have 24 FPS. So it's a little bit of a performance gain. What if we. Oh, cool, it didn't crash now. That's interesting. It's just a one-time thing then. Let's go here and we can go to build select target. We can go to release and go build and run and see if we have any more performance gains with running in the release mode. We got 24 FPS, 25. So not really that much. And it wasn't crashing. It's kind of cool. But is it crashing because we're going all the rectangles? So that's a good thing to show as well. It shouldn't, I mean, it's just we're not allocating any more memory. See here, and if we do escape. Well, it didn't crash this time either, so it was a Windows thing. Anyway, that's the code for the collision, and I hope you are satisfied with that. And this could be like a debug switch later or something. You want to be able to turn this on and off so you can add some flags later in some cool place and say, hey, we want to draw collision rectangles, like if you're in debug mode to see what's going on. But that concludes this tutorial, and I hope you enjoyed it. And hope to see you next time. Bye bye.